हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू री नरिश विद मनीषा। आई एम योर ओन क्लिनिकल डाइटिशियन एंड स्पोर्ट्स न्यूट्रिशनिस्ट मनीषा मेहता। एंड इन द लास्ट वीक्स वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाई मेकिंग वेट लॉस रेजोल्यूशंस इज अ होल लॉट ऑफ अ बुलशिट। वेल, माय आर्ग्यूमेंट इज दैट योर हेल्थ शुड नॉट बी डिपेंडेंट ऑन अ सर्टेन डेट and a certain number on the scale. If you haven't watched this video, I have given the link of it in the description box below, so you can go watch that also after this one. And in this video, I am going to share with you, if I was supposed to lose 20 kilos, well, I haven't lost 20 kilos, but I have lost quite a lot of weight. However, if I was supposed to lose 20 kilos, then what all are the things that I would do? So keep on watching because I am sure you're going to take a lot of value from this video. And in the end, I am also going to give you a special gift, and I'll also tell you the instructions how to use that gift. So make sure that you stick till the end. The first thing that I would do if I was supposed to lose 20 kilos is that I will not panic. Yes, it's a huge number, I know, but panicking over it is not going to be any sort of a solution. Because as I told you in the last video here, that when you are going through a mental fatigue or worry or tension, then your body releases a lot of stress hormones which make you even fatter. So do not panic. Calm down and listen to me. Second thing which I would do is that I will recognize the difference between weight and fat. Yes, these are two different things. Our body is not made up only of fat, and you do not need to lose all of that weight. Because our body weight does not comprise only of fat. It comprises of muscles, bones, blood, a lot of water, protein, minerals, hair, and nails. A lot of other things which you are not supposed to drop off. Plus, if you have a background of workouts, if you have been really active throughout your life, then there is a very fair chance that you might have more muscle than usual people, even if you are a girl. And then in that case, you do not need to follow the instructions of someone who has told you that according to your height, your weight should be so and so, and you need to lose so and so weight. Because you need to look at your composition beyond your just the weight, beyond just your weight, or yeah, you get the point. Third, even if you find out that you have a lot of fat to lose, you can get your body composition test done to find out if you have any fat to lose or not. But even if you find out that you have some fat to lose, even let's say 20 kgs, then understand this thing. This weight hasn't increased in one day. So it is not going to be reduced in one day also. It has taken time to come and it will take time to go also. So do not panic, as I said. Do not be in a hurry to lose all of that weight in one go. My next tip is that you make realistic goals for yourself. If you imagine yourself losing 7 kgs in a month, or you follow these kind of videos and the messages which we get as a spam, or the emails that we get as a spam, that you are supposed to lose like 10 kgs in a month or in a week with that magical product of theirs, and you know, so on and so forth, that's not going to happen. And even if it does, it's not a healthy thing to lose that much weight in one go. Because imagine the kind of shock that you're going to give to your body. So if I give you a brief calculation, 1 gram of fat has 9 calories. So that means to lose 1 kg of fat, you need to burn 9,000 calories. Do you think that is remotely possible that you lose like 90,000 calories in a month? And again, if I give you a thumb rule for how much calories you burn in what activity, you can find it here. And trust me, it will actually burn you down if you burn those much calories. So it's not even practically possible that you lose this much of weight in, you know, such a short duration. So how are they even promising that? Because they are not worried about your fat and muscles. They are just promising you weight loss of 10 kgs in a month. How will that happen? Because when you lose 1 kg of muscle, you are going to lose almost 2 kgs of weight. Why? Because our muscles also store a lot of water, protein, minerals, and all the other good stuff which you are not supposed to lose. So do not fall prey to these things. If they are promising you such an extraordinary weight loss in like such a short duration, it is highly possible that they are going to help you lose muscle, not fat. And that is going to make you weaker, not stronger. And I hope that is something that you are also considering while you're planning your weight loss. And in continuation of that is my next tip that you need to follow an individualized approach towards your health goals. Why that is important? Because every body is different. Yes, biochemically and physiologically, we all function just the same because we are all made up of cells only. However, our lifestyle, our schedule, our workout plan, our profession, everything is different. And that is the reason why everybody's requirements are different. So if you are among those people who tell their cousins, best friends, neighbor that, dude, you have a workout plan and diet plan, give me yours. I'll do that itself. Stop. Pause. That's not going to work for you. Because you are very different than that person. So know the difference. The next tip that I have for you is that the first thing that comes into anybody's head when they want to lose weight is that maybe I need to start running. Or maybe I need to start walking. Or maybe I need to start a dance class. Why this will not work for you? Because these all are cardiovascular based workouts. And if you do long durations of cardiovascular workouts or endurance workouts, you are going to lose some muscle as well. So again, you will be sabotaging your body's nutritional pool in order to lose weight. Yes, if you lose like 1 kg of muscle, you lose 2 kg of weight and you'll be really happy. But that is going to weaken your joints. That is going to weaken your organs, and that's not a risk worth taking. So you need to always have a combination of the workouts. And in continuation of this is my next tip, that you please switch to strength-based workouts. Now, what are strength-based workouts? When you do something against the gravity, like you're holding a plank, that is a strength training workout. Whenever you lift a dumbbell, that is a strength training workout. Whenever you are doing some yoga posture holds, that is a strength training workout. What works for you? That a trainer, a well-educated trainer, can tell you based on what kind of strength, what kind of endurance, what kind of energy levels you have. So start with some weight training exercises. And why it is so important to do strength training workouts? Because when you do strength training workouts, it is like giving a vaccine for a virus to your body. You give a little amount of virus and your body knows how to fight it and get stronger. The same way, when you do weight training, you provide a small quantified damage to your body, and in the pursuit of repairing all of that, your body gets stronger. And that's how we get stronger when we do weight training. And the benefit of that is that your metabolism is going to go up, so you'll eat more, but yet you'll lose weight, which is kind of cool. Second, your heart is going to get stronger. Third, your organs are going to get stronger. Fourth, your hormones, if at all they are mismanaged. If you're a female, you can have your estrogen and progesterone going all over the place. If you're a male, your testosterone levels might be dropping because of the age, and all of those things are going to get fixed. My next tip is that you always should think of the long term. Yes, it is a new year. Yes, you are making resolutions. Yes, you have 20 kgs to lose or whatever amount of weight that you have to lose. But always remember, if you start with something which you cannot do for a long term, the result of that is also not going to stick around for a long term. So if you are dropping your roti, your rice, your grains or millets or all of those things in the pursuit of losing weight, but that is your staple, trust me, you won't be able to stick to it. And there are multiple reasons for that. One, you'll get bored. Second, you have not grown up eating those foods, so it will take a lot of time for you to get habituated to that. Third, your family will go through a lot of trouble and you will miss out on a lot of fun that you can have while you have a meal with your family, because you are going to have maybe dinner at 7 and that's why you won't be eating with your family. Or maybe you are not having something which is made by your mom at that time and she'll have to make something else for you, or you will have to make something else for yourself. And that's just too much of work. Why would you want to do that? Why? So you need to follow a plan which you can do for your lifetime, whether it is about the workout or whether it is about the food that you eat. And in the continuation of that is my next tip, that you change one habit at a time. Yes, maybe you eat a lot of junk food. Maybe you do not drink a lot of water. Maybe you sleep at 2 a.m. But you do not need to change all of those things at once. You can maybe have a small target that I am going to fix my sleep schedule for this week, and then work on that give your 100%. And then maybe the next week, you can start your day with a fruit rather than a tea. And for the next week, do that along with that sleep schedule. And then the third week, maybe start having more of vegetables. And that's how you are going to proceed one habit at a time. And in the due course of time, you will have changed all of your bad habits without even realizing it. And that process is going to be so seamless that it will stay with you for your life, because you have transitioned in it in a very smooth way. If at all any of these tips has resonated with you, please tell me in the comments below. Also tell me which one do you think is going to work the best for you. And in the beginning, I had promised you a free gift, and that is here. I am going to give you a set of guidelines and a rough diet plan that you can do to get started basically. And that is in the description box. So go and download that and get started at least. Then you can stand a chance to have a one-on-one session with me, in which I am going to make a tailor-made diet plan for you as per your schedule, as per your habits, as per your family's habits. So write down in the comments below what you liked about the video, share my video, and then in the end of this year, I am going to give 10 people a one-on-one session. Maybe you'll be one of them, and I am going to be glad to be talking to as much people as possible and discussing and problem solving for as many people as possible. That is the goal of this channel. So on that note, Manisha Mehta signing off. I'll see you in the next week's video. And till then, remember, be a fit foodie, and I love you unconditionally. Bye.